If Quran is well explained, if Quran is well detailed, why do you even need the tafsir? But I'm going to be generous and I'm going to give you the tafsir. So Ibn Kathir is written around 1300 AD. Isn't that correct? Approximately 600 years after the Muhammad received revelation. Can you just clarify for me, how do you trust his interpretation? So first, itself says, Surah 3 verse 106 itself says, on the day of resurrection, faces will turn white, some faces will turn black, and for those faces turn black, did you disbelieve after you believe? Then taste punishment what you used to reject. It is on the day of resurrection. Allah is struggling with the color code.
I know you're talking about
her. The Prophet Muhammad said that Arab is not superior to a non-Arab. The non-Arab is not superior to Arab. The black from the white, nor the white from the black, but those who have taqwa. When we go to a Bayt al-Hajj in Makkah Mahram, when we go in the tawaf around the Kaaba, we are not looking at a person's color of their skin. But when we say, labayk Allahumma labayk, labayk la sharika labayk, inna alhamda wa anni amata, laka la almulk, la sharika la. Every Muslim say this, and no one looking at any color of skin. The imam, who one of the Saudi imams, famous, he is a darker, but nobody is looking at him because of color skin, because it's your taqwa and the knowledge of the Quran and how much steadfast you are in the religion. But in Christianity, you do not have this, because you are the one that have color code in Christianity. And you have slavery in your Bible, Leviticus chapter 25, verse 44 to 46, and you cannot understand and justify these claims now.
Surah 3, verse 106.
I don't need.
On the day, faces will turn white. Not their soul, not their mind, not their heart, but it is their faces. So always their face is going to turn to white. Some faces turn to black. Some faces are going to turn to black. Not to some souls, not to some mind, not some heart, but faces. I want you to explain it to me why their faces are turning to white. Why their faces are turning to black, and why it's happening on the day of judgment.
Allah talks about this on the day, when it says about the faces being black, doesn't mean literally being as literally as a skin color. It means that because their faces became black and because they became disbelieved in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, when the person receives the nur is the light from Allah. Allah says, لِلْرَحْمَةِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا عَبَدًا. Those who dwell by the mercy of Allah, they're in. So the people will attain the mercy or the light or the rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the first to abolish the slavery in Majizan and Arabia when he freed Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhum and other slaves as well in the days of the Yawm al-Jahiliya, the days of ignorance among the Quraysh pagan Arabs.
Okay. If you said Muhammad abolished the slavery, can you please just tell me, how did he abolish the slavery while he was buying and selling slaves? How did he abolish the slavery while he was watching when they were abused? And you talked about the last sermon. Can you please give me when it is that, what is the date that you read that last sermon? Because early sources don't have that lovely version of the last sermon. I wonder why. I wonder why. Maybe because Islam is shamed what happened.
Allah is asking on the day of judgment, you have rejected the faith, means the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that their face has become darkened. But when a face person came bright, it is the nur of Islam, that light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will return the rahmah, the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as wajah, from Surah Al-Imran chapter 3, ayah 107 of the glorious Quran. Secondly as well, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it very clear that he said and he gave the rights by freeing the slaves, as they have the rights in Islam, which Islam provides and gives for the humanity. Because Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind, Allah calls mankind into the duty of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, Christianity doesn't have this. Christianity has a distinct racist problem and a color code problem, that in many of your churches, you have a black church, you have a white church, and all of you are not united. And Allah talks about that in Surah Al-Maidah, chapter 5, ayah 18, verse 21, that Allah says, among the people of you, you don't not never come together. So you though you want to laugh and play but you are the one that being a racist and calling, saying that you, there is no such black Muslim, there's no black Muslim in Islam, and there's no white Muslim in Islam, but it's the word Muslim that believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the deen of Islam. So you're the one who's playing the race card at the end of the day with your hypocrisy agenda.
I appreciate, as a human being who live in 2018, you do not give people color code. Sadly, once again at Speaker's Corner without shame, you went against your Quran. You went against your Islamic teachings. You went against your hadith. Can you fail to explain it to me? Why? Surah 3 verse 106. People's faces are turning the black and white. It is not their heart. It is the day of judgment. Everything is done. Now people are going to go to the eternal punishment or eternal prize. But Allah suddenly decides to put color code on people to send them to hell or send them to heaven. You talked about the rights of slaves Islam gives. I love to see that. Right of the slaves Islam gives. Woman cannot marry with someone without her master's position. Right of the slaves Islam gives. Does Islam offer holiday to slaves? No. Does Islam gives them freedom after certain time? No. If Muhammad abolished slavery, why he still kept his slaves? Why he give slaves to Ali and yeah?
First of all, you should look at your Bible. What it clearly says in the book of Leviticus, chapter 25, verse 44 and verse 46, how to honor what to do with slaves and how to mistreat them and beat them. So therefore, you are playing the hypocrisy standard when you fail not to understand that usul al hadith, which is a science of the hadith. Therefore, you should look carefully in your Bible and do not bring color. In Islam, we do not have color. We don't have a color problem. In Islam, everybody is equal. But in your false religion, you're not equal and you are not accepted. Allah is the one who knows the best with what Allah has sent down and made very clear as well. And then our Prophet Muhammad also made it clear that the Arabs are superior to the non-Arab, the non-Arabs are superior to the Arab, the black from the white from the black. But those have taqwa, that is the best saying of the Prophet Muhammad
This is my second time I am asking you the same question. This lovely version of the last sermon, please provide the date for me, Zachariah. Where is the date? What is the date for the last lovely sermon? I love to see. And somehow no one can chase back to the early time of Islam. I wonder why. Does anyone else wonder why? Because yes. It's not there. So, I am very disappointed as I'm waiting you to provide dates for me. Also, I am very disappointed that as a Muslim, you think it's your right to butcher your own scripture. As a Muslim, you think it's your own right that you can edit to your scripture. Surah 3 verse 106 does not contain the word because of their faith. It doesn't say faith. Why do you think you can add into the word of Allah? It doesn't say that. Surah 3 verse 106 doesn't say that. Rights of slaves under Islam. Sir, it's my turn. You are already stepping into my time. That is very, very disrespectful. But what Islam teaches, what else I can say? This is the example of Islam, what Islam does to people. So, rights of slaves under Islam.
No, she's right.
Slaves cannot choose for herself. They need a proof from their masters. You got cross with me when I talked about, let me read this full story for you. The master does not have a right to force a female slave to wedding, to get married to an ugly black slave. That's what Islam teaches. It's not what I teach. It's not what I teach. This is what Islam teaches. I want you to respond to those things without calling me racist. Because the moment you call me racist, you know what you are saying? You are saying the Quran, which Muslims back down to worship. Muhammad, which Muslims give up their life for, is a racist. I know that.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم القرآن says أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم من رحمتي رب العالمين فرح محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent as a mercy for the whole of mankind. فرح محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم was not a racist because he gave the rights of freeing the slaves, freeing what was happening in the days of Yom Jahiliyyah. What was happening, if you read the seerah and the life of the biography of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will find the answers there. Second of all, you said that we do not have the last sermon of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, we do have the last sermon of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well.
What's the date,
that's
please?
Also claimed he had clearly
shut up, he had clearly as well
no that dates. He mentioned the about the equal rights of every person. It doesn't matter if it's Arab or non-Arab. The non-Arab is to be the Arab, the black from the white from the black, but those who have taqwa. Who do you know who can say this today? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most influential man sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the face of this earth, and a lot of non-Muslim scholars know this, and even Dr. Bar Ehrman knows this, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not just a prophet, but the one of the greatest messengers of God. So you should be very careful what you are saying as well. Secondly as well, you're using foul language, foul racist language. You are coming here to divide Muslims, like black Muslims and the other Muslims, but there is no color in Islam. There is no black Muslim and there is no white Muslim. We are bin nahl al-muslimun, that we submit to our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have the problem in Christianity yourself. You haven't rectified the problem in Christianity. You are in this society and they'll never accept you at the end of the day. So that shows you as well that your own religion you came to follow is it doesn't give you the right as well, and has done a lot of the slavery from the 16th to the 18th to the 1900s and beyond that, more and more. Inshallah.
I'm
going to
do my last statement. So, let me just start with the claims you made about me and about Christianity. He's my brother. I don't care about his color. Me and him, we are all one in Christ. And my brother will give up his life for me. I will give up my life for him. This is the teachings of the Christ. This is the teachings of the Christ. So, I ask you to give me the date. Those lovely last sermon you preached, which you claimed Muhammad did. No dates. You came to me and then you said, I am making a claims about Islam which are false. But we've done a couple of rounds. You did not prove anything false. You just mumbled.
Surah Al-Imran chapter 3, ayah 106, ayah 107.
It's my turn, and then I can see already respect is going. You talked about the surah. It is the same surah which tells us Muhammad trade people as slave. He practiced the slave trade. As I said, you didn't give me the dates for the last sermon. You talked about Muhammad is the most influential man. Yes, he is. He made the history being the false prophet. He made to the history with coming and denying the Lord Jesus. He made the history while he was 54 years old, he had a sex with a girl who is 9 years old. He made into the history by getting married with his daughter-in-law. He made it into the history by trading slaves. He made into the history by giving people color code black and white.
No,
of course, he is the most influential man because he takes the dignity and value of mankind.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
That's my conclusion.
Why do you lie? You're saying
my conclusion is.
Ah, you're not interested.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent li rahmati li rabbil alamin. He was a mercy for the whole of mankind. As I said before, in Islam we do not have color code. In Islam everybody is equal and has the same rights.
That's not
in
true.
Christianity. Quiet, Quran, my time.
Quran,
my time, quiet.
It's not your time. I already made my conclusion.
Islam is the fastest growing religion and Jesus was a Muslim. Those that have Christianity was false. Christianity also is white supremacist that draws a white Jesus, blue eyes, blonde hair, and pale skin. Why do you yes?
That is not in the
yes,
Bible.
Because they do that as slavery. That you have the color code. You have color code in your Bible. Color code is in your Bible. Do you want to admit that now? Do you want to admit that now that there's a color code in your Bible that you don't? Because you want to be hypocrite. That therefore you are a racist. You are Islamophobic. You are coming to attack Islam and Islam is at the same end of the day. You are a liar. You are a liar at the end of the day. You do not know what the Quran said clearly about you misuse the verse of the Quran, Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, ayah 106, ayah 107. So it makes it clear that in your Bible says to own slaves. And you don't know any because you are a foreigner in this land. You are a foreigner in this land. You have no rights and they will give for you.
Have a good night, God.
Yeah, the who, Allah.
I am looking forward to Allah.
It belongs to Allah. It belongs to Allah.
Home,
it belongs to Allah. And you get paid for this. You get paid for
Yahweh.
This. You get paid for
I
this.
I am paid by the blood of
really,
Christ.
Really.
Amen.
And Dr. Bar-Ehrman refutes your claim. Dr. Bar-Ehrman calls you a heretic. But Dr. Bar-Ehrman calls you a heretic. You are a heretic. Dr. Bar-Ehrman calls you a heretic. He calls you a heretic. Jesus is Jesus worshiped the Creator.
He
Jesus never knelt on the cross. You are